Welcome, everyone. Thank you for joining us in today's webinar. My name is Aditi, and I look after marketing for Tatvic Analytics. To give a brief introduction for all our new users, Tatvic is an authorized Google Marketing Platform partner for Google Analytics 360, Google Optimize 360, Data Studio, and Google Tag Manager 360. We are also one of the leading providers of digital analytics solutions and consulting for SMEs and large enterprises. Today, this webinar is on 5 advanced Data Studio dashboards for digital marketers and data advocates. It is going to be presented by Viraj, who is a customer success manager at Tatvic, and Yaman, who leads the implementation team here at Tatvic. Viraj, Yaman, you would like to come in and say hi to our attendees today.
Hi, guys.
Hello. Thanks for joining us today.
All right. Okay, so I just have a few things before we get started. If you have any questions during the presentation, please feel free to type them into the question box in your GoToWebinar control panel. I will bring them up at the end of the presentation, and we'll be sure to answer as many questions as time permits. You can also leave us a feedback or ask us the question on Twitter. Our handle is Tatvic. I am online on Twitter as well. All right, so I'll be carrying out a couple of polls as well during the webinar. It'll help us to know you guys better. And we also have a very cool takeaway for all of you towards the end of this webinar. So please stay tuned to find out what that is. So, all right, before we get started, I will launch my first poll. You guys can let me know what data visualization tool do you use. Maybe it's Data Studio, Tableau, Excel BI, or something else that you're using. The results are really interesting. I'm just going to share the result really quickly. So 76% of our attendees today are using Google Data Studio, 5% Tableau, 10% Excel BI, and 10% are on other visualization tools. Awesome. That's really insightful. Thank you so much for taking the poll. Without any further ado, I will turn this session over to Viraj and Yaman. Guys, you want to take up?
Sure. Thanks, Aditi. Hi, guys. This is Yaman. So the today's agenda is we'll be presenting 5 dashboards initially. Then we'll introduce a data blend feature. Then we'll have a Q&A session. And as a token of gratitude, you will get a free takeaway. So in 5 dashboards, we'll be covering e-commerce dashboard, web performance dashboard, then readers engagement dashboard, and video content engagement dashboard, and social listening dashboard. We'll be presenting these dashboard alternatively. So Viraj will start with e-commerce performance dashboard. Viraj, over to you.
Thanks, Yaman. Let's get started with our very first dashboard. That's e-commerce performance dashboard. So the name itself suggests it's a performance dashboard, and that's why it focuses more on the key metrics of the business for an e-commerce client. So the audience for this particular dashboard is CEO, CMO, and board of directors, and this will be focusing on the key metrics, what goes around the key metrics, and it will provide you a single interface to analyze your business data. So let's jump onto our dashboard over here. And so over here we can see that on top of the report that we are showing revenue as a dependent metric on the 4 independent metric over here. So basically this calculation visual shows that session, conversion rate, average quantity, average price are the 4 independent metric on which revenue metric is dependent. And that's why when you multiply this all 4 independent metric, you will get exactly revenue amount. And the comparison for this metrics is compared with the previous month. And here we can see that there is drop of 36% in revenue compared to previous month. This drop is being contributed by conversion rate. If you look at this 4 independent metric, there is a drop of 37% in conversion rate, and that is impacting overall revenue drop. To drill down further, we will go through this conversion funnel. So here we can see that session is increased by 1.8%, but the actual drop is at add to cart event. So basically users are visiting your product detail page, users are viewing your product, but they are not doing add to cart. So find out a problem over here, whether it might be because your products are showing out of stock and users are not able to do add to cart, or your add to cart CTA is not performing as per your expectation. So you may run out to your product team, to see their inventory of out of stock products, or you may run A/B testing for add to cart CTA. This kind of insights you may get from this particular report. Just below this metric, we see a revenue contributors chart. So this trend is basically a week over week comparison of four independent metrics and one dependent metric, that's revenue. So it shows the change in revenue compared to previous week, and what the change in revenue is contributed by this four metric. So this kind of analysis you can do using this simple plot over here. Moving to the other chart, which this particular chart is very interesting over here. So this is basically three dimensional plot of product category. Here the size, this circles in each circle shows product category, and the size of circle is shows the volume of product revenue, and on the x-axis it shows the quantity, number of quantities sold for those that particular product category, and on the y-axis it shows average price of that particular product category. So here what kind of actions that you may take is you can focus on this particular product categories over here, which is having high number of sales, which has high quantity, and you may try to do a price A/B test and move this product to slight upward direction, which may result into an overall increase in revenue. So this kind of A/B test which you may run for this particular product category, and you can optimize your revenue opportunities for different product categories. Apart from this plots, we have also considered checkout funnel over here. Checkout funnel is basically steps of your order summary and payment screen and at last transaction. Then we have covered session level information like how many, what kind of user type you have, new versus returning ratio in terms of sessions and transactions, top 10 geography location, top 10 cities, I would say. Then of course the channel part, like what channel are performing and what channels are not performing to drive conversion on your website. And at last, there is a campaign details, ROAS metric is also covered over here for the campaigns. And that's all you can analyze through this particular dashboard. So to coming back to slides, what value this particular dashboard will generate? It will always talk about the key metrics and what goes around those key metrics. It will share you insights like that, and it will provide you a common interface where you can interact with your charts and business data, the most important business data, and help you to take actions. Moving to our next dashboard, over to Yaman.
Hey guys, so it was a really nice dashboard, Viraj. Some of the useful actionability we can take from this dashboard that you have presented. So next dashboard in line is a web app performance dashboard. It is a dashboard designed for your tech indicators on your website. So to improve conversion rate, apart from your marketing efforts, your development effort is another pillar to work upon. And in recent trends shows increase in newer technologies coming up in market for delivering faster content to users. For example, progressive web apps are there, accelerated mobile sites are there. It is equally important to monitor your tech KPIs to stay on top for providing better user experience. Your tech performance of your website directly affects the conversion rate. To support these sentence, I have few case studies with me as well. For example, Walmart experienced up to 2% of the increase in their conversion rate with every second of page load time they reduced. I have a case study of Amazon wherein 1 second of increase in page load time could cost Amazon $1.6 billion of sales in a year. And even Google said increasing latency from 100 millisecond to 400 millisecond reduced their daily searches by 0.2% to 0.6%. So while studying all these case studies, we thought of designing a web performance dashboard, and we tried and integrated every useful information it will in the dashboard. It will definitely help you generate value for your development effort, and it will relate the performance metric with conversion and revenue metrics. So these dashboard is basically designed for CTOs, for development team, for website owners, and for data analysts. So let's look at this dashboard. So this dashboard is divided in four different parts. We'll start from the top. Every part is a deeper analysis of the above part. In the top, if you'll see, there are basic insights related to page load time, which are there. Two most important things to look at are average document interactive time, which denotes actual time when your web page is becoming actionable to users. The lesser the document interactive time, higher the probability of converting that user. Then average page download time is there. Now this is the very interesting insight we have generated, like combining the page download time data with users' internet speed and page size data. So we have worked upon these three metric, and we have improved the page download time metric. So by that, the conversions are improved. In the second fold, it shows the relation between conversion and page load time. So left hand side graph is specifically designed for lead generation site, wherein they can see the relation between conversion and time taken to submit the lead. In the other side, e-commerce specific graph is there, wherein you can clearly see that the the transactions are higher when the page load time was lower. In the third fold, we have combined many other dimensions like browser version and devices. So it is one step drill down of a second fold only and combines the data of second fold. You can clearly identify browsers with higher page load time has lesser conversion rate, even if the users are higher. And the other chart says the same story. Now, what is the actionability? By which point you can start taking actions to reduce your page load time? So final fold will give you that actionability. Now, if you'll see JavaScript errors, the client side errors that are happening on your site, you can identify and you can clearly see browser wise error happening on a different pages and what share of that browser is contributing to those errors. Right. If you can see the metrics which are there on the right hand side, we can see the difference between conversion of all users and conversion of users with the errors. The numbers will definitely motivate you to take further actions. Right. So this overall Power Pack dashboard is your true performance monitor. As and when you want to monitor your performance KPIs, you need to look at this dashboard. So this will clearly establish a relation between your conversion rate and a performance website, and it will help you understand where your website is broken. Right. So this was all from the web and app performance dashboard. The next dashboard in line will be presented by Viraj.
Thanks, Yaman. I really like the information, the details that you have covered in this particular dashboard. That's very interesting. Okay. All right. So coming to our next dashboard, it's a reader engagement report for digital publisher. And this particular report is for senior executive or a content director. The dashboard that the data that this particular dashboard covers is majorly focused on the key metrics, four key metrics. One is engaged readers, story views, Story views is basically the page views where stories are published. GAM revenue is basically Google Ads Manager revenue, which is again based on the monetized page with the page views where stories are published, where ads are shown, and the average time spent on the story. So basically that is average time spent on the page where stories were published. On this top report, we have considered date range as last 7 days, since it is a kind of weekly data, and the team monitors their key metrics week over week, and that's why we have covered weekly trend over here as well. So if you observe a trend over here, you will clearly see a correlation between engaged readers, story views, and GAMP revenue. So you can simply identify any drop or spike over here. If you see certain spike in story views, then it is a kind of indication of viral content or virality for certain kind of content. So to cover a bit more detail about these key metrics, we have drilled down these key metrics based on two main dimensions for this for a client. So one of them is source and the other one is article category. So what metrics this particular table talks about is from Google source, we are getting the highest number of readers, and the pages per session metric shows basically the engagement. So and the metric over and the third metric that we are covering over here is GAMP ECPM. So GAMP ECPM is basically revenue per 1,000 story views, and this denotes the performance in terms of engagement and as well as the revenue that what sources and article category is generating to your website. This table is basically, the objective of keeping this table is to focus on key important article categories that generates good amount of revenue, that performs well on your domain, and the sources from where you get your quality traffic or readers on your website. And the last part is talking about the demographics and geography of reader. It talks about from where user is coming from. So top two states are Uttar Pradesh and Maharashtra. So this is where your readers come from. If we talk about age group, then it's 18 to 34. The high majority of your traffic is from that particular age group. Devices, talking about UIs, 85% of your readers use mobile device. And if we talk about gender ratio, then it's 70-30 for male and female respectively. So that's pretty simple. What we have covered over here on this particular dashboard. The idea was to focus on key metrics and highlight only important things that really matters for this business. And what we have considered is lot many time people overdo on while creating some dashboards. They cover lot many metrics. They put in lot many charts and graphs over a report, but doing so, the context or the primary goal to communicate insights is missed out on those kind of cases, and there is no single unified way of or I would say unified purpose for a dashboard. And that's the major point, that's the main point that we have considered for this particular dashboard, and kept it very limited to as per the audience. That's it on readers engagement report. We will move to our next dashboard. Will be presented by Yaman.
Thanks, Vigaj. I really like the way you said that people include so many reporting stuff in a single dashboard, which probably leads to lesser actionability on those data, and somehow people fail to derive insights from that data. So yeah, it was a really an amazing dashboard that you have presented. Let's move to the next dashboard. This dashboard is basically focused on video content site. On-demand video platforms are increasing today. And especially in India, there are many platforms like Hotstar, Voot, TVF, Sony Live, AIB, and even Book My Show, which caters video content with different genre to users. They work in this area, they generate their revenue. In our experience of working with such clients, we have received few queries for data, for extraction of data, for reporting. I would really like to highlight those queries as well. Like how long is video watch time by different geography? How did this video perform against other video in series? What is the revenue attached with this video? Or a very simple question, can I forecast the popularity of this video? By these all these queries that we have received, we have concluded that video content sites are focused upon the popularity of video content, video engagement metrics, video actions like play, pause, stop, and up to how much length videos are being viewed, content delivery metrics like video buffer time, media player errors that are happening on client side. So to answer all these questions, we have prepared a video content dashboard. So this dashboard is basically designed for product managers, content strategy executives as well. So this dashboard is divided in four different parts. It includes the revenue related insights. It includes video engagement insights. It even includes sales funnel if you have a subscription based video content store. And it includes a traffic source performance and contribution to the revenue of those traffic sources. So let's look at this dashboard. Very first of all, shows the revenue related numbers, a pretty simple insights which can be fetched from analytics only. Now second fold shows the video related number, by which you can see total videos viewed every day on your site, top 10 genre that are being watched on your site. Others are engagement metric. If you'll scroll down, you'll get device-wise bifurcation as well. And you will get the traffic trend versus the revenue trend of your site. Now, in the second fold, it is a very niche insight that we have crafted specifically for video content site, wherein you can identify or you can see the average video watch time by different platforms. In Android, what is your video watch time? In iOS, what is your video watch time? In website, what is your video watch time? By which you can definitely take actions like on which platform you need to optimize your videos, right? So these are the very niche metrics for video engagement related. Now if you have a subscription based revenue model, so we can leverage the enhanced e-commerce functionality of Google Analytics only. We can set up the entire sales funnel for you, wherein you can get the holistic picture of users viewing the video to users purchasing your subscription plan and generating the actual revenue for your website. If you look at the right hand side of the report, it shows the entire sales funnel wherein these many users have viewed your video, then they have clicked on CTS, then they have viewed the plans that are there, then plans are clicked, then payments are initiated, and then unique purchases are done. So entire sales funnel is visible to you. Then how the social buttons on your site are performing, and then the contribution of different sources to your website and contribution of revenue of those sources as well. So this entire dashboard is specifically well crafted for video content site, and it definitely gives you actionability. It definitely gives you insights by which you can decide your future strategies, right? So what value it adds, it adds to your business is your view time is your revenue, right? The larger the view time is, the greater the revenue that you will generate. It clearly establishes the relation between video metrics and revenue metrics. And it also gives you the holistic picture of users and their journey across the website and across the app, right? So that's the dashboard related to video content engagement. Now, next board will be presented by Viraj.
Thanks, Yaman. So the last dashboard is social listening dashboard, and this is something very innovative that we have done for one of the brand. So The audience for this brand will be brand director or CMO. The example that we are using is Twitter handles data over here. So we have done this particular analysis based on one of the brand's Twitter handle, and we can see tweets, favorites, and followers. So by the this all data which is presented on this particular dashboard is a open source data, and it's readily available through Twitter API. Okay, so on the right hand side there are certain key metrics which denotes the social presence performance, and the definitions for these particular dashboards are mentioned at the bottom of this report in case someone is not aware of the definition of any of this metric. I will go through a few of the metrics which are quite interesting or important for a social presence performance. One is content score, which denotes average number of engagement happens on a particular post. So the higher the number, higher more good it is for a social presence. The other one is response rate, where it denotes number of replies that your Twitter handle do to the users who have actually tagged your handle in that tweet. So the response rate is basically for this particular Twitter handle is 0.31. It's like 31%. And the one of the other metric which is very insightful over here or very useful is social reach. So social reach is basically indicates the potential that you can reach through this Twitter as a handle. So social reach is a total of follower plus follower of followers. It is a potential that you may reach through your Twitter handle. So at a high level, we have covered three sections for this particular report. The first one is tweets engagement. Tweets engagement in terms of it shows a stacked bar chart by different engagement per day. The more interesting part for this particular section is trending tweets and top influencers. So you can identify your trending tweets through engagement activity happens for a particular tweet. Based on those trending tweet, you will be able to find your top influencers on Twitter as a handle. I would say this is something very useful information for any of the brand, because these are your top influencers. You may contact them and you may spread out certain word of mouth, or you can run your brand campaign through by engaging with them. So this is very insightful for this particular report. The other section talks about sentiment analysis for the tweets where your handle is getting where your Twitter handle was tagged, and using this particular analysis you may identify your reviews, especially negative reviews, where you can work upon and improve your services or product. So there is a list of tweets as well. You can simply filter out negative tweets and work on that. Most interesting part is hashtag virality, which shows you the hashtags which are getting more traction on your tweets. So this particular so for an example, if you use unethical as a hashtag in your tweet, you will be able to get a good virality of your tweet. The viral potential is calculated for each hashtag. It is based on the number of retweet that you may receive for a tweet when this particular hashtag is used. So yeah, overall it covers the performance of your social presence, and it encourages some actions based on the analysis or data that we have on the social listening dashboard. That's it from the dashboard side. Moving to our next topic on agenda, data blend.
Hi Viraj, I'm sorry, I'm just going to jump in real quick and launch a quick poll since we're done with the dashboards, and I think they were pretty amazing as well. Thank you so much for taking us through insightful dashboards. I'll just run a quick poll to understand if you guys liked our dashboards and you want us to get in touch with you for your visualization and dashboard requirements. If you say yes, either Viraj Yaman or I will get in touch with you and figure out a way where and how we can help you with the same. And before we move on to the data blend feature, Rajat has raised his hand. I'm just going to unmute him and let him ask his question. Hi, Rajat, you there?
Rajat?
I guess we can't connect with Rajat. Okay, then thank you again so much for taking the poll, and over to you, Viraj. We can move on with our session.
Thanks, Aditi. All right, so coming back to our slide.
All right, Aditi. The new feature that we are going to talk about is data blend. And let me give you a context over here. So let's say if you want to get a valuable insights, you might bring in data from different data sources. Then you might want to combine, analyze, visualize those data as a whole. So when you combine multiple data sources or multiple data sets on a common parameters, your visualizations give you better context of your data, and that's make your data really helpful. So for an example, you might want to join your daily sales data by geography region with the region's daily average temperature to see how temperature is affecting your sales. If your business has been an ice cream manufacturer or something related to that, then this kind of information might have been very helpful to you. So Data Studio lets you bring in data from different data sources and visualize them side by side on a single dashboard page. However, data blending feature will let you join those data sets and analyze, visualize them in a single visual component. Let's see how easily data blending works in Data Studio. I will walk through a hands-on example over here. So we will first go to datastudio.google.com. I have created this particular report for this example, for a hands-on example. So I have already connected two different data sources. The first one is Google Analytics, and the second one is the stock market price for a particular client for whom we have connected Google Analytics account. So what we are looking for is we want to plot these two information on a single visualization component to get a clear context of the data. So what we have to do, I will simply plot a new chart or simply copy the old one since I already have it on the page. Then I will go to settings, click on blend data. Since the chart is already using one of the data source, that is Google Analytics, it will appear over here. What we have to do, we need to add another data source in the chart, and that's where we will add stock price as another data source. And the field that we want to plot over here is closing stock price for a particular data set. That's all you have to do. You simply need to click on save, and your chart will be updated. I will do a few modifications on the chart. I will plot stock closing price on the right hand side. We'll show points, and that's all. This will give you a better picture compared to a two separate visualization. You can also use a filter control if you have any, if you want to slice your data based on certain dimension. You can also use date range over here to slice or dice for a particular time of the year. And there are a number of things that you can work based on your data.
I have one more example that will show a proper use case of data blend as a feature. So here it shows we are bringing three different data sources to a single visual component. So this kind of features can help you to give you a unified way of visualizing your data. That's all about data blending and the dashboards that we covered. Okay, over to you, Aditi, for a Q&A session.
Thanks, Viraj. All right, so we are now at the favorite part of my favorite part of the webinar. It's the Q&A. I already have quite a few questions that we're going to start taking up one by one. Viraj and Yaman will take turns in answering these questions to you. In the meanwhile, if you have questions, if you have more questions, please feel free to get in touch with us again. Send us your questions. Okay, so time for the first question. Pramod is asking if the browser errors pulled from the browser errors that we've pulled are from analytics or from Search Console.
So, hey Pramod, Yaman here. So we have set up
Google Analytics tracking for JavaScript errors via Google Tag Manager, and there were certain custom tracking that we have done for clients. So the error data is combined data of those two errors. Is it satisfied?
Pramod says okay. Thanks, Pramod. Thank you, Yaman. All right, on to our second question. Nishant is asking that at times we get an error of configuration incomplete, and in that case data is blank. He's asking, how do we resolve this?
Hi Nishant, Viraj here. So we also were able to figure out this error, and then later on we identified that there was some change in data source that has resulted in this error. So what you have to do, you need to go to edit part of edit view of Data Studio dashboard, go to manage added data sources from the settings, refresh your data source. You will surely identify certain change in data source, and then reconnect the data source and refresh data on the report. That should solve your problem, and this has worked for us as well.
Thanks, Viraj. Nishant, I hope that was insightful for you. If you have more questions, please feel free to ask us. All right, our next question is by Pooja. She's asking, how can we get video metrics in Google Analytics? Yaman is our expert on video content engagement. He's going to take your question.
So Pooja, whenever you implement video tracking, whatever player that you're using, each player has their APIs with it. APIs will give you metadata related to the video that is being displayed. Every metadata can be pushed to data layer, and via data layer, those data can be sent to Google Analytics. So you need to have an understanding or a final goal where you want to reach, or which kind of reporting that you're looking for. Basis on that, you can design the strategy of your implementation, which kind of data that you want to pull out and send to Google Analytics, and how you want to view your report. So you need to decide the scope of custom metrics and custom dimensions that you are pushing to Analytics, and then you need to pull out the exact and correct report from Google Analytics to view the video related content.
Pooja, I hope that's helpful for you. Do let us know in the chat if you have any more questions. Ronak is asking if data grouping is possible in Data Studio.
Hi Ronak, Viraj here. Yeah, so to answer your questions, data grouping is very much possible in Data Studio. So there is a very cool feature within Data Studio that's calculated field. Using that, you can group your data within your dashboard and data source itself. So so one of the example that I would quote over here is about default channel grouping. So you get channel grouping, default channel grouping as a dimension when you connect Data Studio to Google Analytics data. But there is also certain there is also one feature called custom channel grouping, wherein you group your source medium values based on your custom requirements. So that particular use case you can implement through calculated fields within Data Studio. If you require any help on those fields, those calculation formula, we will be happy to help you. Please feel free to reach out on that.
Cool. Ronak, I hope that was helpful. On to our next question. Vineet Kumar is asking, are errors handled exceptions or errors like 404? Yaman is going to take it up since it seems a little technical.
So the errors can be both. So 404 errors are less in numbers, while if you will see the exceptions errors which are happening on your client side or front end code are higher, and those are the errors which breaks your entire functionality. So yeah, both the errors can be tracked and both the errors can be resolved, and you can regenerate the use cases considering the Google Analytics data only.
All right. It seems Ronak has an added question. Sure, I'll just unmute you, Ronak, so that we can have a conversation and we'll be able to answer your questions. Give me just 1 second. Hey, Ronak, you there?
Yes, yes, hi, Ronak here. Can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yes, so basically my question is around default grouping. As he mentioned, we have custom channel grouping. But while using Data Studio, I basically cannot view it as in how do we use it. So to illustrate an example, so say if I have the search campaigns, right, and I have various campaigns in search. So how do I group them all and see a complete search channel like we see in Google Ads? Is it possible in Data Studio?
Hi, Ronak, Viraj here again.
Hi, Viraj.
Yeah, Ronak, so it's very much possible using Data Studio calculated field that you can group your search values to a particular channel. So basically, you are talking about custom channel grouping as a feature which is available in Google Analytics. You want to get that field in Data Studio, right? So directly, it's not available in Data Studio, but what you can do is you can use your source medium values which is already available in Google Analytics. You can use calculated field metric, calculated field feature within Data Studio, using which you can write down few formulas. The best formula that fits for this particular requirement is regex match formula, and you can combine it multiple sources to a single channel. And that's all you have to do. You need to create a new field within Data Studio, and that's all you have to do over here.
If possible, can you just share a template with me, as in how do I do it with steps?
Sure, Ronak, we will be able to share you a template and also an example formula for your this particular use case.
Okay, thanks Viraj. How do I get those formulas and the templates?
You can simply email to our hello email ID, hello at Tatvic, and we will be able to reach out to you as soon as possible.
Okay, I'll do that.
Hello, Ronak, Aditi here again. You can also, I'll just ping you my email ID. You can write into me as well, and I'll take care of this.
Yes, sure, Aditi. Please do that.
All right. Thank you so much for your question. I hope you've cleared any doubts you had.
No, nothing else.
All right. Okay, so on to our Martin has a very interesting question. He's asking if we can compute custom fields in blended data. Viraj Yaman, he's saying that the last time he checked, this wasn't possible. I am assuming it's still the answer is still the same, but Martin, Viraj will take you through his version of the answer, his perspective.
Hey Martin, Viraj here. Unfortunately, we still don't have any such feature to use custom field or custom metric using a blended data as a feature. So basically what we can do over here is we can unify both of those data data sources in a Google Sheets or a BigQuery, which is a kind of SQL in a tabular form. And then we can connect that single data source to Data Studio. And then you can use custom fields within Data Studio. So this is a kind of workaround that you may use by the time we get this feature enabled on Data Studio. And that would be my recommendation based on your requirement.
Martin, I hope Viraj was able to answer your question. All right, so Gurpreet is asking, how can we apply a section access for particular users, suppose on the basis of event specific or product category or Mumbai, for example?
So Gurpreet, you can simply use segments. So the segments that you have created on analytics will be there if you are a data source owner, and system specific segments are also available. So basis on segment, you can categorize your audience. You can also use filters depending on the chart or depending on the on the table that you are using and the insight that you are generating. Both of them will do and will answer your question.
All right, Gurpreet has a question to follow that up. He's asking how to apply set analysis.
So if you have seen the Explorer tab, wherein it shows that you can combine two or three subset of audience and you can analyze whether the audience are intersectively available or matching on certain areas. Like for example, if I just want to analyze audience coming from Mumbai and audience coming from some other region, some other city, then I can create those two segments. And in Explorer tag itself, there is a report which will help you to generate this analysis.
All right, Gurpreet, I hope that answers your question. If you have any more questions, please write to us. Feel free. Now, I think we are on to our last question. We have a few more questions. Guys, we are actually running out of time. If we haven't answered your question, please be sure we will get in touch with you personally over an email to answer all the questions. Kostub is asking, what are some other use cases of data blend? Viraj, can you please elaborate a little bit more on data blend and maybe some more use cases?
Sure, Aditi. Hi, Kostub. Viraj here. Talking about data blend as a feature, if you have offline stores and online store as well, so you might need to analyze both of your data in a single place on a single visual, I would say. So, and then you can slice your data based on certain geography or based on other parameters as well. So I would say data blend is one of the key feature in that case as well. If you have offline data, online data as a separate tool, on a separate tool or in a separate place, you can bring that up at a single chart, and that makes your or visual component or chart very useful for you. So this is where you can analyze your region-wise offline sales. That's a use case I would recommend over here.
All right. Thank you guys so much. All of you, thank you for these amazing questions. If you have any follow-up questions, please get in touch with us on hello@tatvic.com. And we're actually, since we're running out of time, I apologize, but we have to end our Q&A session here. But if we have missed out on your questions, Yaman, Viraj, and I, all of us, will get in touch with you personally on an email and answer your questions. They won't go unanswered, I promise. All right, so as promised, we are on to our token of gratitude for all of you who've stayed right till the end. It is a free takeaway, a ready-to-use Google Data Studio template that we have created for especially for you guys. Viraj will quickly take you through the how to use it and the overview of this template and give you an idea of how to use it. Viraj?
All right, sorry for the technical glitches. So let me go through again. So this particular dashboard has a date range of weekly. It shows a week over week comparison. This dashboard was prepared keeping in mind e-commerce as a business. And if you have any, if you belong to any other domain, you simply need to change the metrics which are available over here on the top of the report. There are certain few other visuals which can be applied to all the business, all the domains, irrespective of e-com, lead gen or publisher. To use this dashboard, you simply need to click on this, copy this report over here on the top of the report in the menu bar. And when you click on that, you simply need to select your new Google Analytics data source and click on create report. Once you click on create report, a copy of this report will be generated with all the data updated with your Google Analytics data. That's all you have to do, and the report is ready for you.
Wow, that sounds easy, guys. If please use this Data Studio dashboard. I have I'm sending out the link to you in the chat right now. I will also include this in the emails that I send out to you as a follow-up of this webinar with this recording as well as the PPT deck. If you have any issues while using this dashboard, please write to us at hello@tatvic.com. And like I said, the recording and the PPT will be shared with you in the next 24 hours. Thank you so much for attending. Guys, it was a pleasure. Yaman, Viraj, thank you so much for giving us so many insights.